Hello and welcome to my workshop.
And okay, so to tell Mach3 the size of the table, because it's set at the moment, I think, at 100 millimeter by 100 millimeter. So that's in home and limits, and this is the screen that you actually tell Mach3 how big your cutting area is, or your cutting envelope. So the X axis is, I'm actually gonna, I can say 600, and the Y is 900. Now, with mills and actually, when I say mills, I mean milling machines and routers, the Z axis, the zero position is at the bed. And so here we put minus 200. And the zero position is actually when it's the saddle or the tool is fully up to the top of the gantry. And we're going to press OK. Now then, we're going to put a G-code file into Mach3 now to give us something to work from.
Okay, so
we'll put
the Harley Davidson Eagle in there. All right, see, this is much bigger. So we'll zoom out.
And you can see that that is more sizable in relation to... Okay. So at the moment, it thinks that the center of that job is sat right there on in actual fact, the job is not on the table at all. So to move it onto the table, what you would do, would jog over. Yeah, that was my fault, because I forgot to set the program. I actually made, when I wrote the program there, I, there we go. Now we've moved it over into the center. So, we know where it is. So, that one is set. So what we need to do now is to set the soft limits and tell the machine where its extreme, or where its home position is, which should be down in this bottom corner here. So hopefully it already knows it, but I think it might. So to do that, you turn this on so it's red. That's the machine coordinates, and that's what these DROs are doing now. They're actually showing me where the machine thinks it is, or how far it is away from the home switch. Okay, if you look at the DROs now, I'm pretty close to the far extreme corner here. And if you notice that the Z, as you zero at the top of the axes, that should now be okay. So if I press ref all, okay, now the machine knows that that's its home position, or the extreme outer edges of the cutting area. And from that point, it knows exactly how big a cutting area it is. And I'll rely on the soft limits, because I've already put into Mach3 that the plus X is 600. So when it reaches that 600 limit there, the machine will automatically
as the DROs count down, when it gets to 600, it will stop. It will slow down and stop before it bashes into the side of the gantry. Okay, so if I turn that on, that's the machine's home position. Now if I turn that off, the DROs are actually showing what is known as the G54 work position. The G54 work position is really just a coordinates for Mach3 to know exactly where to start cutting that piece of work. And from the program, of that piece of work, it knows how big it is. So if we zoom into that, you can see that this line here and this line here actually shows the how big the actual item is, or the piece of work. So that is the difference between a G54 coordinate and a home coordinate. So we'll leave it on there and we'll run the program. And to run the programs, just simply come down here. Obviously I'm dry running, I haven't got the machine turned on. So we'll start up here, and I do like to do a dry run. So at the moment it's taking the really know what was going on there, but there you go. And there it is cutting. So now all we've got to do, I suppose, is put a tool in and give it something to do. I hope you've enjoyed watching this video, and if you have, please subscribe, press like, pass it on to your friends, and as always, little red box up in the top corner there, if you press that, that'll take you to my YouTube channel where you can enjoy yourself. So thank you very much for watching, and bye for now.